The Schluter Curti Shower Kit offers everything needed to create a waterproof, vapor-tight shower assembly. The kit contains all the components necessary to prepare your shower for tile in one convenient package. Let's take a look at what's inside. A roll of Curti waterproofing membrane is included, which is used to protect walls from moisture penetration. You will also find Curti Band waterproofing strips to seal all seams and connections. Curti Carrick preformed inside and outside corners are supplied to easily seal vulnerable areas of your shower. A Curti Seal PS pipe seal and a Curti Seal MV mixing valve seal are included. These are used to seal pipe protrusions and protect moisture-sensitive solid backing panels. All kits contain a Curti Shower T, TS, or TT sloped shower tray with integrated Curti waterproofing. The trays are available in a variety of sizes and configurations. You also get a Curti Board SC shower curb, which is waterproof, lightweight, and ready to tile. And finally, a Curti Drain floor drain with an integrated bonding flange that connects to the Curti waterproofing membrane on the tray. Curti Drain accepts the included fully adjustable square grate assembly. Curti shower kits are available in a variety of shapes and configurations. Some kits do not include the drain or grate to allow for more flexibility in flange and grate selection. Let's take a look at how to install the kit. Always refer to the Schluter Shower Installation Handbook, which provides specific installation requirements and instructions. Now let's start by installing Schluter Curti waterproofing membrane over the walls. In this shower, gypsum board is used as solid backing, though other panels, such as tile backer boards, may be used instead. If the Schluter Curti Board SN prefabricated shower niche sold separately will be used, consider installing the niche prior to the Curti membrane. Please refer to the Curti Board SN shower niche within Curti assembly video for details. The Curti membrane is bonded to the walls using any of our Schluter thin-set mortars or an unmodified thin-set mortar. The mortar is mixed to a fairly fluid consistency, but still able to hold a notch. A 1/4 inch by 3/16 inch V-notch trowel, or the Schluter Curti trowel, which features a 1/8 inch by 1/8 inch square notch design, is used to apply the mortar. Wipe down the walls with a damp sponge to remove any dust. For particularly dry and porous substrates, it is recommended to wet the substrate first in order to help prevent premature drying or skinning of the thin-set mortar. Apply a thin layer of mortar to the wall with the flat side of the trowel to produce solid contact with the surface, and then comb additional mortar using the notched side of the trowel. The walls must be covered with the Curti membrane up to the shower head at a minimum. Embed the Curti membrane into the thin-set mortar using the flat side of the trowel or a drywall finishing knife to ensure full coverage and remove air pockets. Periodically peel the Curti back to check for coverage. Proper installation results in full contact between the fleece and thin-set mortar. Re-embed the membrane. The Curti membrane application is continued on adjacent walls. Waterproof integrity is maintained at joints by using a 2-inch overlap. Here, we are demonstrating a lap seam on the plumbing wall. In a lap seam, the second piece of Curti is placed over top of the first with a minimum 2-inch overlap. Be sure to get the Curti tightly into the corner without damaging the membrane. Next, on the back wall, we will install Curti band over a butt seam. In a butt joint, the Curti sheets are placed edge to edge, and then covered with a piece of Curti band centered over the joint. Using the flat side of the trowel, apply thin-set mortar to the area where the banding is to be installed. Then, apply additional mortar using the notched side. Embed the Curti band into the thin-set mortar. Since Curti band is one-half the thickness of the Curti membrane, buildup at seams is minimized using this method. Next, we will install the Curti seals at the pipe protrusion and mixing valve. Apply thin-set mortar to the area where the Curti seals will be installed. Place the seals and embed them into the mortar. Schluter Curti Seal PS is used to seal protrusions through the Curti membrane at the showerhead. Schluter Curti Seal MV is used to protect moisture-sensitive solid backing, such as gypsum board, at the mixing valve. As an alternative to using the Curti seals, Curti Fix or other suitable sealant can be used in these areas. The walls are now waterproof and vapor tight. Schluter Curti Shower T, TS, and TT prefabricated sloped shower trays are made of lightweight expanded polystyrene with integrated Curti waterproofing. They are ideal for constructing shower bases and can be cut to size with a utility knife or extended with dry pack mortar as required. If there is access to the plumbing from below and the waistline can be connected to the Schluter Curti drain after installation, the tray can be installed prior to the drain. When there is no access to the plumbing from below, install and connect the Curti drain to the waistline prior to the installation of the shower tray. Please refer to the No Access Plumbing Demonstration with Curti Drain and Curti Shower Trays video for this method, and return to this video when that work is complete. The substrate must be clean, even, and load-bearing. Any leveling of the floor must be done prior to the installation of the shower tray. The shower tray is installed using any of our Schluter thin-set mortars or an unmodified thin-set mortar. A 1/4 inch by 3/8 inch square or U-notched trowel is used to apply the mortar. Apply a thin layer of mortar to the subfloor with the flat side of the trowel to produce solid contact with the surface, and then comb additional mortar using the notch side of the trowel. Place the shower tray and solidly embed in the mortar. Cardboard can be placed over the tray to protect it. Next, we will install the Curti Carrick inside corners and Curti band along the tray-to-wall connections. Completing this step now will help us to avoid working over the shower curb later on. Using the flat side of the trowel, apply thin-set mortar to the area where the Curti Carrick corners will be installed. Then, comb additional mortar using the notch side of the trowel. Embed the Curti Carrick using the flat side of the trowel or a drywall finishing knife. Repeat the process at the remaining inside corners. Holding one side of the corner in place while embedding the other side in the mortar helps keep corner installation simple and easy. Next, we'll use Curti band along the perimeter of the shower tray. Measure and cut sections of Curti band so that a 2-inch overlap is achieved at all junctions. A 2-inch overlap can be achieved at Curti Carrick corners without continuing Curti band all the way to the corner of the shower. This will limit buildup of the membrane in these areas and make setting small tiles easier. Curti band may be creased prior to installation to help maintain tight corners and make subsequent tile setting as easy as possible. Using the flat side of the trowel, apply thin set mortar to the area where the banding is to be installed. Then, apply additional mortar using the notch side. Embed the Curti band into the thin set mortar using the flat side of the trowel or a drywall finishing knife. Repeat this process at all remaining joints, ensuring that the minimum 2-inch overlap is achieved at all transitions. The next step is to install the Curti drain bonding flange. Fill the step in the shower tray completely with thin-set mortar and apply additional mortar up to the cutout in the subfloor. Press the Curti drain firmly into the mortar to ensure full support of the bonding flange and check for level. Using the flat side of the trowel, apply thin-set mortar over the bonding flange and within the recessed area of the shower tray surrounding the drain. Then, comb additional mortar using the notch side of the trowel. Center the included Curti collar over the Curti drain and embed using the flat side of the trowel or a drywall taping knife. Clean the excess mortar from the step in the bonding flange. Make sure this connection is secure. Next, we'll install the curb. The Curti board SC is installed using any of our Schluter thin-set mortars or an unmodified thin-set mortar, similar to the Curti shower tray. Keep in mind that the curb can be easily cut to size. Apply the mortar to the subfloor, edge of the shower base, and walls. Press the curb firmly into place. Verify that the curb is level. Now that the curb is installed, we can complete the remaining waterproofing connections with Curti Carrick and Curti Band. The Schluter shower system is designed to be flexible and meet the needs of the installer. Depending on project requirements and installer preferences, the order of Schluter Curti waterproofing installation may vary from that demonstrated, provided that all surfaces are covered and 2-inch overlaps are maintained at all seams. The waterproofing installation is now complete. If tile is to be set on floors adjacent to the shower, consider the use of Schluter Ditra uncoupling and waterproofing membrane, which can be sealed to the Schluter shower system to provide comprehensive waterproofing in the bathroom. More information is available in the Ditra Connection to Shower Base video. A water test is recommended before setting tile to verify a successful waterproofing installation. This evaluation may be required by building code officials on some projects. Wait 24 hours after the membrane installation is complete before water testing. This will allow for final set of the mortar and will ensure waterproof performance of the assembly at seams and connections. Please refer to the How to Perform a Water Test video for this method and return to this video when that work is complete. Next, we will install the grate assembly. The grate assembly is installed in conjunction with the tile. Fill the step in the bonding flange with thin-set mortar. Then we place the height adjustment collar inside the lateral adjustment ring. Be sure to back butter the underside of the grate to help ensure full support. Press the assembly into the mortar and install the surrounding tiles, ensuring full coverage. Position the grate to match the joint pattern of the tile covering and press flush with the tile surface. Remove all excess setting material immediately. Schluter profiles can be used to replace sealant joints and finish tile edges in shower applications. The integrated Schluter shower system eliminates leaks, reduces efflorescence and mold growth in the system, and dramatically reduces installation time to ensure success and make shower installation easier than ever. If you still have questions, please contact our customer support specialists. For more information on Schluter products, visit Schluter.com or check out our YouTube channel to view our videos.